All right. Shalom. Want to start sending our praise and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Rakakadash. All right, double honor to our apostle, Elder's great millstone, peace and mercy be unto the Lord's elect out there, teaching the word, truth and sincerity. I'm the brother Amar.
Brother Ma'akador.
Khan. You know, brothers got done getting it in at the gym, but we just wanted to hit a quick in transit video. And we just going to hop right into it without further ado. And we just going to hit the scriptures real quick.
Jeremiah 5:19. And it shall come to pass when ye shall say, wherefore doeth the Lord our power all these things unto us?
Right, because Jake want to know why the Most High fucking them up, pretty much. And what it is, it's simple. It's because you not obeying the Most High, man. The scriptures say in Deuteronomy that we like children unto the Heavenly Father. And if you got physical children in your real life, you going to want them to obey you. You ain't going to want them being rebellious and disobedient. And then when you say this, they go opposite. That's how the Most High look at us, man. So the reason why the Most High punishing us, because you simply sinning. That's why. It ain't no other special, you know what I mean? It's you sinning. You going against the Heavenly Father. Go ahead, Ak.
Then shalt thou answer them like as ye have forsaken me, mm-hmm, and served strange gods, mm-hmm, in your land, to, mm-hmm, so shall ye serve strangers in a land that is not yours.
Right, you know what I mean? The Most High said how, because pretty much when you look through history, when you read the scriptures, all right, Jake, that always been our problem. Jake's problem always been abandoning the Heavenly Father, all right, and then they'd go a whoring, like the scriptures say, after other gods, meaning they go seeking the other gods, like whatever that god might have been, might have been Baal, you know what I mean? Apis, the bull, fucking Serapis, Christus, any god you can think of, rather, that was always Jake's problem, you know what I'm saying? Right. That's Jake's problem to this world. A lot of times now what Jake's problem is worshiping the Queen of Heaven. And then it's money. The scriptures call that mammon. Yep, thwadog. Scriptures say you can't serve two masters. But that's Jake's problem. Is Jake don't want to actually abide by the Heavenly Father in his way, man.
Jake don't want order.
Yeah. Jake don't want order, man.
Jake hate the law.
God,
just like you see, you know, Jake break Esau's law. Yep. Jake just hate law. It's just in 2/3 of our people to just hate law. They hate order. Mm-hmm, all right, because, mm-hmm, to a certain extent, Esau's law brings a little order.
Huh.
All right, you know, that's why to a certain extent, you got to follow some of Esau's law.
Yeah, because we in captivity. That's why, for brothers that, like, you know, you can't get that, you know, I'm an Israelite, man. Fuck you, Esau. I mean, it is fuck Esau, but you can't be like that in the system because it's not our setup.
That's right.
And then you be going, matter of fact, give me Romans 13 real quick, verse 1 and 2, because you will be going against the Heavenly Father. You know what I mean? The Lord got Esau in rulership, so we got to listen and adhere to that.
Right. This is Romans 13 and 1. Let every soul be subject, mm-hmm, unto the higher powers.
Right. It said, let every soul be subject unto the powers.
Higher powers.
Yeah, higher powers, right. Because Esau, he is a power right now. And we're souls. So the Most High has set him up. Why? Because scripture say the earth was given to the hand of the wicked. And this is Esau's rulership right now until Yahusha come back, until we can get our kingdom. So right now, we got to be subject unto the powers. Go ahead. The higher powers.
All right. It says, for there is no power but of Yahweh, mm-hmm, the powers that be are ordained of
you
Yahweh.
See that? Yeah, the powers that be are ordained by the Most High. So whoever the Most High set up, rather that been us under the Egyptians, us under the Romans, whoever, we had to be under captivity, and we got to still, but we got to move with salt and seasoning. That's why when we, we at work, you was gonna go cursing out Esau. Right. Like, hey man, you a Edomite, you gonna drop dead and all that. The Most High gonna kill you. You don't be doing that, man. You gotta move with salt, man, because you gotta be subject according to the higher powers. You
gotta put on your Clark Kent.
Yeah, you know, hell
Superman,
yeah,
Superman ain't Superman 24 hours man, a day, yeah, man.
No, right. He got the Clark. When he Clark Kent, bro, he at work. He acting like he don't know nothing about none of that, bro. But then after he leave that bullshit job, he going to save the world. That's what we doing, man.
That's right. When we at camp, That's our time to, say what we gotta say. But then outside of camp, we gotta, be wise as a serpent.
Yep, yeah, con. Yep.
All right, verse 2, it said, whosoever therefore resist the power, resisteth the ordinance of Yahweh.
Yeah, so there you go, man. Brothers, like, that's an answer for you right there, man. Don't be resisting the powers, man. Agree with our adversary quickly, man. You gotta deal with the way the Most High got everything set up, because at the end of the day, this is what the Most High want until Yahweh shall come back, man.
It says, they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation.
Yep, yeah. So if you resisting, you're going to receive to yourself damnation, meaning you're going to get even more trouble, man. You know, Esau pull your ass over, and then you like, oh, man, fuck you, man. I ain't got to listen to you. I'm an Israelite. You an Edomite. Then he going to take your ass about the car, beat your ass half deaf. They going to drag your ass into the fucking precinct, wherever the hell you going, the holding. hold right. himself.
But it's Jeremiah 5:20 yep. declared this in the house of Jacob and published it in Judah, saying, "Hear now this, O foolish people, and without understanding, mm-hmm. which have eyes and see not, mm-hmm. which have ears and hear not."
Yeah, that's our people. They got physical eyes, physical ears, but they can't see nor hear, man. Scripture say this is Most High have given that blinded them, man. All right. They're blinded because the angels got the blinders, the spiritual blinders over them. Because it's crazy because how we can explain all this and a baby, a little kid sometimes can get what we're saying. But Jake, you know, they don't understand it because the angel blinding them. You know, you want to say something?
No. Okay, verse 21. "Hear now this, O foolish people, mm-hmm. and without understanding, which have eyes and see not, which have ears and hear not, mm-hmm. fear ye not me? Yep. Save the Lord."
Yeah, the Most High, like, you don't fear me? And let's see what it say.
It says, "Will ye not tremble at my presence, mm-hmm. which have placed the sand for the bound of the sea, mm-hmm. by a perpetual decree, mm-hmm. that it cannot pass it?"
Yeah, man, look, when you look at the way that the Most High set everything up, the sun and the way the animals move, all that, you like, damn, man, this whoever did all this, they got hella power, man. You supposed to be able to fear that, man. Or you see a person get judged and get his ass fucking ran over, you supposed to fear that, man. You supposed to be like, damn, the Lord got control over all this. He can end my life at any time. I can get a fucking I can get some crazy ass disease or illness while I fucking drop dead. I can die in my sleep. You supposed to be able to, man, you supposed to fear that,
and
man.
And the Lord say, "I want to leave to fall from a tree."
Man,
and the leave fall from a tree. And the Lord know exactly how many hairs you got on your head.
Yeah,
man.
That's crazy power, Ock. That mean the Most High, and that's just not one person, that's everybody. That mean the Most High, he see and know all everything, man. Come on, man. Why wouldn't you fear some entity like that, man? Someone like that.
Go ahead. It says, "And though the waves thereof, Shalaki," mm-hmm. it said, "though the waves thereof toss themselves, mm-hmm. yet can they not prevail."
Right, because that, like, when you look at an ocean or a sea, like, that's crazy. Like, the sea and the water be coming, and they don't even go past that, man. That's crazy, man.
"Though the war, they cannot pass over it."
Yep, because the Most High, he set a boundary that they cannot pass, man. Just like how he said Esau, he set a boundary that Esau cannot pass, man. Esau be trying to figure out certain things. He ain't going to figure it out because the Most High, he gave him a position where he can't go past,
That's
man.
That's right, brother. Good. All right, it says, "But this people have a revolting and a rebellious heart."
Yep.
"They are revolted and gone."
Yep, that's Jake, man. Revolted and gone, man. It's to a point Jake don't even want nothing to do with the Bible. Jake look at it like, if you reading the Bible, he look at you like, you weird, man. Oh, you all niggas reading the Bible, man. You corny. Or
but Jake got one. You
right.
know, but Jake just used their Bible as a trophy.
Yeah, yeah.
As a display. Or I'm holier than thou.
Right, man. Keep it resting in the back of the damn, you know, car window. You know what I mean? Some niggas even roll up blunts with it or whatever.
Yeah, that's right.
Like breaking down weed and shit. Go ahead.
It says, "Neither say they in their heart, let us now fear the Lord or power that giveth rain, both the former and the latter in his season. He reserveth unto us the appointed weeks of the harvest."
Right. They don't even got it in their spirit to be like, you know what, man? Let's just chill out, y'all. We been too wicked. Let's try to do right by the Lord. They ain't even thinking like that. They think is... Jacob's thing is Isaiah 1, the first chapter, verse 3 on down. They're going to only revolt and get worse, man.
Right.
You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Verse 25, "Your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sins have withholding good things from you."
Oh, so that's the reason why Jake the rest of the reason why Jake in this messed up position is because of this verse right
that's
here.
Right.
It said, "Your iniquities," bring that verse back out.
This is Jeremiah 5:25. "Your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sins have withholding good things from you."
Yeah, so next time you niggas, when you ain't getting whatever you trying to, whenever you call yourself praying for, when you at your bed, it's because you sinning, man. You niggas got the nerve. These niggas got the nerve to ask the Heavenly Father for something when they just got done doing some fucking wickedness, man. That shit is so insulting, and it make brothers mad because it ain't like it's impossible, man. The Lord say, "Grow a beard, grow a beard." The Lord says, "Don't do this, don't do it, man." And yeah, of course, we're going to fall short because we're in the flesh, but he wants you to try, at least try.
Rehearse.
Yeah, rehearse,
that's what
man.
Rehearsing about, because when you're in a movie and you know that the fucking mm-hmm. actor fuck up and
yeah.
the director say cut, you know,
mm-hmm.
he started right back over.
Yeah.
And try to do it a different way until
yep.
he get it.
That's
what rehearsing about.
That's right, y'all. Yeah, and then when you read, like the brother said, like the brother Ma just said, when you, the rehearsing part, Judges 5:11, man, there shall it, in the place of drawing words, there shall every hearse the righteous acts, man. This is all about the Lord seeing your true colors, who you really are. If you a person that say you believe in God, and the Lord like, okay, you believe in me, at least try to do what I'm doing. At least try to do what I require. And the Lord like, oh, you ain't doing it, you ain't a real person. Because Jacob swear up and down, I'm the realest nigga. I'm a, for our women, I'm a bad bitch, and I'm the realest, I'm the, all that. You ain't shit, man, because y'all don't want to acknowledge who y'all really are.
That's right.
The thing with brothers, we acknowledge that, look, I ain't shit. You know what I mean? I know I'm just a regular person. I just want to do right by the Lord. I just want to be righteous. But Jake out here, they full of pride, man. They still think they somebody in America, and you working a 9 to 5, and your ass get that Tuesday, that two to them 2 days off, right, and then Jake fronting, man.
Jake fronting.
Fronting, man.
Hey, Monday, Friday, Saturday, Jake in the club, and then Monday, yeah, they back in that depressed.
Man, what?
Working to make that, yeah, little bit of coins that you gonna blow.
This is a pathetic life, man. I can't understand the mindset of a 2/3, man. Why would you want to stay here? The Lord promised you a better position. All he wants you to do is fight for him so you can wake up the Lord's elect and get in a better position.
Hey, that's like you know, Jake being offered a business,
mm-hmm,
position at a desk, mm-hmm, a $200,000-$300,000 a year salary, mm-hmm, job, mm-hmm, and they turn that down to work at McDonald's.
Yeah, that's exactly what it's like. They take the worst position rather than the better one, man. What a nigga. Go ahead.
All right, verse.
That was it. Go to Isaiah. Was that, or did you ask someone?
No, that was it.
All right. And then we're about to end it out on
this. All right, this is Isaiah 59.
Verse 1 and 2.
And 1. It says, behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened,
yep,
that it cannot save.
Right. Yeah, because it ain't that the Most High can't get you out of your predicament that you in. If you in the ghetto, you fucked up, you ain't got no money, you ain't got that. It ain't that the Lord hand is shortened that he cannot save, because he can do whatever he want. He can save you. It's just that you still not doing right. Most High probably looking down at you like, look at this dude, man. Still ain't doing right. Still ain't. I ain't about to save you. Go ahead.
It says, neither his ear heavy that it cannot hear.
Right. The Most High, when you throwing up them prayers, you don't think the Most High hear you? It ain't that his ear too heavy. He hear you. It's just he ain't listening to what you're saying because you going about it the wrong way.
That's right.
First of all, Jake don't even know how to pray. They think this praying not. That don't got nothing to do with how you righteously pray, man. All right, Jake.
They pray for cardinal shit. Like, yeah. Lord, I want a car. I want $1 million.
Man. Yeah, I want this big house. Why? So all that is vain, man. It ain't got nothing to do with serving the Heavenly Father. Jake don't get a prayer like, hey, Lord, could you increase my understanding in the truth? Can you increase my understanding in, you know, serving brothers better or serving you better? It's all about carnal means to this life, man. Can you give me a better house? I want more money. Why? So you can go in the club and flex on niggas? That's all vain, man.
Verse 2, but your iniquities have separated between you,
yep,
and your power.
Yep, see that? And that's the same, pretty much the same verse you just read in Jeremiah 5 and 25, man. It's your iniquities, man. It's your sin that separated you from your power, the reason why the Most High ain't doing, he ain't fighting for you, man. It's just that simple. There ain't no science back behind it. It's because you sinning, and that's the reason why the Lord ain't on your side. That's the reason why we keep getting messed up as a whole. And it ain't gonna get better until Jake acknowledges that. Well, not the whole Jake, but until the elect acknowledge their sins and come back to the fold. That's all we're waiting on. And then Revelation 7 chapter gonna kick in. Once the Lord's elect is sealed, that's when Yahweh Bashem Shah gonna get busy. But did you have anything else?
Yeah. Oh yeah, you said that's when the Lord gonna get busy, because yep, Jake got the opportunity now to, yep, you know to get this, man. But you know, mm-hmm, Jake not preparing himself. Jake not trying to come back to the Lord,
yep,
once again.
Yep.
So you said this is when the Lord gonna get busy, and this is, you know, close with this. It says Ezekiel 7:14, mm-hmm, they have blown the trumpet even to make all ready, but none go up to the battle. Mm-hmm. For my wrath is upon all the multitude thereof.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. they said my wrath is upon all the multitude thereof, man. All right, Jake, the reason why Jake getting judged left to right is because, like I said, you ain't doing right by the Heavenly Father. Therefore, wrath is upon all the whole nation, man. All right, once Jake get right, we going to be good, man. And, you know, got anything else?
No, that was it.
All right, con. Hey, with that, we're going to give all praise and glory to
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Rekon Kadash.
All right, double honors to our apostle Ezra, great millstone, peace and mercy be unto the Lord's elect out there. Shalom, a Baba Boy.
Baba Boy.
Con.